Okay, so before we move on, let's just, I don't think we've had any exercise yet involving the factorial, right? So Celica asked about number 30, 11.4. So what kind of test can we use here?
Ratio.
So we said that when there is a factorial, usually you use the ratio test, right? How does the ratio test work?
N plus 1 over n, a of n plus 1 over
you
n.
You look at the expression a sub n plus 1 over a sub n, right? And then what do you do?
You do it.
So you do it. A sub n a sub n plus 1 means you replace the n by n plus 1. So let's do that. So that will be, let me use brackets. So instead of n, you will have n plus 1, right?
Yeah.
And then factorial, correct? Okay? Over 2 to the n plus 1. Let me write the 2 to the n plus 1 here. Do you understand why I switched it over here?
Yeah.
I think I explained this over the other day, right? Okay. This is the a sub n plus 1, correct? You follow? Instead of writing it here, I wrote it here because I'm trying to group like what?
Terms.
Well, I don't want to call them terms, but what? Factors, right? Okay. So like factors. And then divided by a sub n is really the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of a sub n. The reciprocal of a sub n is 2 to the n. So I can put the 2 to the n here, right? And then I have the 2n factorial here. Is this expression clear where this came from? Any questions? You good?
Yes.
Right? And then it's a matter of simplifying this, right? Which part is easy to simplify?
The right.
The other part.
2 to the n over 2 to the n plus 1 simplifies to what?
Yes. 1 half.
1 half, right? Everybody clear why it's a half, right? Because this is 2 to the n times 2, correct? So the 2 to the n's will chop, okay? So you have a half. Clear?
Yes.
Now what is the meaning of this? 2 times the quantity n plus 1 is the same as 2n plus 2, right? Factorial, correct?
Yeah.
Over 2n factorial. Now, do you remember what factorial means?
Keeps going and going and going.
Like if you have 5 factorial, what is the meaning of 5 factorial?
5
times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, right? So in other words, you start from the first integer, then you keep subtracting 1. So let's look at this. You have the quantity 2n plus 2 factorial, so what does that mean? You start with 2n plus 2, right?
2n plus 1.
Then you have 2n plus 1, correct? Mm-hmm. You subtract 1, then you'll have 2n, correct? Mm-hmm. 2n minus 1, 2n minus 2. But what are those guys after? It's just 2n factorial. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Correct? Like going back here, 5 factorial is really the same as 5 times 4 times 3 factorial, right? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay? So 2n plus 2, the quantity factorial is 2n plus 2 quantity times the quantity 2n plus 1. And all the rest will just be the quantity 2n factorial. You get that?
Yeah.
Okay? And so we don't have to mess with this, right? You can just leave it alone. And what can we do?
Cancel.
Then you have a half right here. So now we are ready to examine the limit as n becomes large or infinite. So what happens to this?
Infinity.
It will be infinity, right? Over 1 times a half. Half of infinity is?
Infinity.
Infinity. Therefore, since the limit of the ratio is infinity, what does that mean? That means that the given series is what?
Divergent.
Divergent.